Good morning. I know you, well, I guess you can't see me now. Jim just pulled up in front of me here. We just came to our first client's house. We were here yesterday finishing up the transfer switch and everything for our 24 kW generator that we installed with them. This transfer switch is powering up two 200 amp panels for the home. Today we're here nice and early, as you can tell, because we've got the power to be shut down by We Energy. So that's our first thing on the to-do list, is make sure everything is prepped and ready so we have no issues whatsoever. Nice, clean, efficient, and quality install. Let's go. Might be wondering why we turn off all of the loads to the home before We Energy's disconnects power outside. It's because since there's no load running then, there's way less likelihood of any sort of an arc flash happening, since there is no current flowing through the system. With everything off, not gonna happen for him, so much safer for himself outside doing his work. Excuse me, looking all rough without my shirt tucked in. What we're doing now is we've got these feeders for the panels coming from the transfer switch. I am sizing them up, cutting them down, stripping the wire back here. And some of our keen viewers might have remembered from yesterday, we were talking about the bonding bolt and as well as this little tie bar right here for the ground, since these are now sub panels and our neutrals and grounds have to be separated. I'll show you exactly what that looks like. See, this used to be what is bonded to the panel frame and ground right here. So we're gonna take this little screw out and pop it in right there. And then this bar, which is connecting our two terminals, this is now neutral, this is ground, will also be pulled out, so they're totally separated. You might have seen my face there. What we're looking at is basically, it looks like there's a strap holding our entrance cable in. So it went from, you know, pretty easy to kind of difficult to get these out of here now and replace them with our new ones. So we're brainstorming right now. Even sometimes what should be a simple job ends up being a little more complicated than you would think. All right, so far it's been a pretty interesting day. We've had a couple of different problems when putting in the service entrance cable that we came across. That's just gonna be the way it is sometimes. So we had to get in there with a multi-tool, chop some stuff up. A couple of different bars that were absolutely stuck in there. So we had to use a multi-tool again for that as well. Inspector is gonna be here in a little bit, but I've gotta take off before we get that thing up and running because I've got a phone call to make. We have a customer that has an emergency where she's got some outlets catching on fire, a couple of different neutral issues with her house, you know, with the lights flickering and stuff. Basically, that's gonna be an issue between either neutrals being set up incorrectly, or it could be also an issue with LED bulbs. If you get LED bulbs and fixtures that are not supposed to be taking LED, I know they're supposed to be able to just plug and play, but that's just not the way it works, depending on how the neutral system is set up in the home. So if all that stuff isn't right, that's definitely going to cause an issue. So we got to check that out. First, it's going to be a phone call to see if I can gauge the situation and severity of it, if it's something that we need to get out there right away with, or if it's something we can set up a quote over the phone. Most likely, this is going to be a call where I have to get out there personally and take a look at it, because it seems like it could be a pretty severe safety issue. And then we've got a meeting here at 12 o'clock with our marketing director. So that's going to be a blast. I'm really excited to talk about and game plan with some things that he's done with the company and see what he's doing, what he's working on currently, in different ways that I can help twist his brain a little bit. Now that I'm with professional services and pushing them and marketing for them, you can probably sense it. I am extremely excited. So that's going to be fun. And also later today, we got an inspection too. So it's a busy one. Time to go. Another day in the books. We finished up with the panel inspection for the homeowner. So he was able to get the lien release on that property and get it sold. That's proprietary information on how we do that. So I'm not going to show you that. But all this to say that we are the qualified experts that are going to show up when you just can't get anybody else on the line. We're gonna make sure that we get out there for you and are ensuring that you have a great experience at the same time. The big lesson of today, which I pushed at as well, was to always be building value. I don't just want to go into a home, complete the project, and then walk away. I want to make sure that that customer is 100% satisfied and that we're on their mind for the next visit or for the next thing that might pop up in their home that we would have to take care of. Instead of them calling somebody else, they're gonna call us next time. Completing the job with not only accuracy, but with heart in mind is how we stand out from the others and really provide that service with a wow. Another way I'm building value is ensuring the customer that I'll be following up with them in about 30 days. Checking in to see that everything we've installed is still in perfect working condition, they are happy as a customer, and to see if anything else has come across their mind in the meantime, which we could help them out with. We're always providing a valuable service for you as a client. Remember, if you need quality service from us, or I'm sure maybe you know somebody who's been looking at doing their next electrical project at home, we've got you covered. Whether that be Ozaukee, Washington, or Sheboygan County, you can give us a call today. Thank you all so much for watching today's quick little recap, and we'll see you in the next one.